Hey man, by the way, I made you something. I'll bring it over later.
Oh yeah?
It's got drawers in it.
Oh, is it?
I made the drawers with rabbits.
You did what?
Yeah, rabbits. And then I clamped them up.
You clamped rabbits?
Don't worry, I made sure they were square so they'll fit in the carcass.
The rabbits are square.
Not just the rabbits.
I'm sorry. What?
I was gonna use dovetails for the drawers, but I figured rabbits would be a lot easier. I'm sorry about that.
Just the dove's tail? Where'd you even find rabbits?
Full disclosure, I cut the rabbits on my table saw.
You cut rabbits on your table saw?
Look, there may be any number of sharp tools that can cut a rabbit. I just happen to prefer the table saw.
We've got our own language in woodworking, so when you're first dipping your toe into this hobby, you could be forgiven for getting a little bit confused. So let's talk about the most common woodworking terms so you know what in the world's going on. A workpiece is just a piece of wood in your project, but it's the piece that you're currently focused on. When we say something is square, we're talking about a square angle, which would be 90 degrees. The end of a workpiece is square when the edge is at a 90 degree angle to a face. The whole workpiece is square when all edges are square to each face. A carcass is the main body of a project. Probably the best example is in cabinet making. The actual box of the cabinet is the carcass, and then you add face frame and doors and drawers and so on. When you see wood separate along its length from the outside in, that's called checking. The wood dries quicker on the outside than the inside, so the outer wood contracts and then it separates. And as the wood dries further and further towards the center of the tree, that check gets deeper. When wood bends across its grain, that's called cupping. Now you'll usually see this most in wood flooring because the top may be sitting in the sun and it dries quicker than the bottom. The bottom has more moisture. So because the top is contracting quicker than the bottom, it cups towards the top. But you can also see this not long after milling up a tree or as a tree dries. Because all the wood fibers are held towards the center of the tree, and once you mill up a piece of that, it opens up and wants to pull back and release all that tension. A glue up is just simply assembling a project with glue. You've got all the pieces cut, now you need to put them together and attach them permanently. That's a glue up. When you drill a hole in preparation to drive a screw or a nail, that's called a pilot hole. Sometimes this is called pre-drilling, but you can't drill a hole before you drill the hole. That's insane. Milling is just cutting wood to a desired shape and size. You can cross cut, which is cutting wood across its grain, or you can rip cut, which is cutting wood along its grain. Now, when you're milling up wood, you'll have the piece that you'll want to keep, and then whatever's left over, that's called an off cut. Tear out is when you get wood fibers that lift and chip along a cut. And this is caused by the way a saw exits the cut and it lifts those fibers up on the edge. If a piece sticks out from the surface around it, it's said to be proud of the surface. If you have an inset portion of your project that's inset from maybe the frame around it, that's called a reveal. A reveal can be a nice way to add depth and interest to your project. Woods that come from a conifer tree are called soft woods. Those are woods like pine, spruce, and fir. Woods that come from deciduous trees are called hardwoods. Not all hardwoods are in fact hard, especially some of the harder softwoods can be as hard or harder than some of the softer hardwoods. Those are just general labels that we've given these two types of woods. The slot removed by a saw blade as it's cutting is called the kerf. A rip fence is a movable guide that's parallel to the blade and allows you a really nice reference when you're making a rip cut. You most often see them on a table saw, but I also added one to my crosscut jig for the circular saw. A stop block is an offcut that is secured in place and used to make repeatable cuts. So you would slide your workpiece up to the stop block, make a cut, slide it up to the stop block again, make another cut, and there you've got repeatable, consistent sizes. Wood grain is the figure or design that you see in wood. It's caused by the different layers, the different rings in the wood, and the texture of the wood fibers for that particular species of wood. End grain is the grain at the top and the bottom of a tree, or looking at the wood fibers from the top or the bottom. The long grain or the face grain is the wood grain that runs parallel to the center of the tree. So long grain is like looking at the side of a tree trunk, and end grain is like looking down or from the bottom of a tree trunk. A mitered corner is a way to join two pieces of wood when each of those pieces are cut to an angle that is not 90 degrees. The vast majority of the time, you cut those two angles so that when they come together, they make a 90 degree angle, although you don't have to. You can make it greater than 90 or less than 90. When we say we're gonna break edges, that just means we're gonna soften a sharp edge or a corner by sanding it or planing it. Joinery is just the method in which we join pieces of wood together. The simplest example of joinery is called a butt joint. And it is the simplest because there is no interlocking or overlapping of the pieces. You just simply push them up against each other and either glue them up or fasten them or both. A bevel is any angle on the edge of a workpiece that is not 90 degrees. A rabbit is a soft woodland animal that digs holes in my backyard. Kidding. A rabbit, or a rebate as it's called in the UK, is a recess cut into the edge of a workpiece so that it can be joined with another piece. It's very similar to a butt joint, except you're giving it just a little bit more perpendicular support. A dado is very similar to a rabbit, but where a rabbit has one side and then it's open to the edge of a workpiece, a dado is positioned somewhere in the middle of the workpiece and it's got two sides. Now that you know how to speak woodworker, you'll want to know all the tools that you'll need. So check down below, there's a link to a free download that'll tell you all about that. And then head over to this video and I'll see you over there.